your holy place. We bless you. You are high and lifted up. We just thank you, Father. We just thank you, O Lord. Great and mighty are you, seated on the throne. We just bless your holy name. bless the Lord. Let me tell you the type of religion it is. That's the computers kicking in. They couldn't keep up with it. I'm not kidding you. Every time we come to that place of blessing the Lord, it can't handle it. We've seen stadiums that go out. More than once, the power outages, the computers, the processing speed cannot keep up with him who is the time is in his hands, faster than the speed of light. We just bless you, Lord, how awesome. But we behold the glory of the Lord. We behold it. God goes up with a shout, and the Lord with the sound of the trumpet. Yes. Oh, yes. Let the earth hear the sound of our God. Lift up your voice.
Holy, holy.
Yeah.
Thank you.
they dance before you, giving you glory and honor and blessing. We bless your holy name. For who is like unto you?
Because of your cross, Jesus. You are merciful, you are wonderful, and you are beautiful, Lord, and we bless you. We bless you and we honor your name, Lord. We honor your name, and there is no God like you, Jesus. We bless you, Lord. We bless you and we thank you, Jesus. We thank you because you finished the work in the cross, Jesus. Because it's finished, Lord Jesus. And we rejoice in you, Lord. And we rejoice in your grace, in your mighty love, in your mighty power, God. In your beautiful promises, Jesus. We bless you, Lord. We bless you. We thank you, Lord. And we honor your name, Lord. We honor your name, Jesus. Name above all names, Lord. Name above all names. There is power in you, Lord. There is power in you, Jesus. There is power in you, Lord. You are beautiful, Lord. You are wonderful. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for living your Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, thank you, thank you, thank you for the living waters. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. It is your mercy. It is your grace. It is your love. And we bless you and we bless you and we honor you, Lord. I see your rushing waters, Jesus. And I thank you, Lord. And I thank you. You know that we are a thirsty land, God. You know our souls, our hearts, our minds. Nothing is hidden from you, Lord Jesus. You know everything. And there are no secrets before you, Jesus. And you know our need and our hearts are in need of you, Jesus. We bless you. We honor you, Lord. We call on your name, Jesus, on your mercy, on your grace. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. Hori of a higher reveskindi, Hori of a handa reveskindi, Hori of a higher reveskindi, I will also sprinkle clean water on you, and you will be clean. I will cleanse you from all your impurities and all your idols. I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit within you. I will remove your heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. I will place my spirit within you and cause you to follow my statutes and carefully observe my ordinances. Then you will live in the land that I gave your fathers. You will be my people and I will be your God. I will save you from all your uncleanness. I will summon the grain and make it plentiful. I will not bring famine on you. Father, we bless you, Lord, and we thank you, Jesus, and we honor your name, Lord. Thank you for this amazing privilege, Lord Jesus, to have your word, Lord, so vivid in our hearts, in our minds, in our lives, in our spirits, knowing, Lord, that our battles, Lord, the things that we battle against, those things that seem impossible for men to get rid of, Lord. Those things, Father, that sometimes make us feel weary, Lord, and ready to give up, Jesus. Those things you say, I will pour out my waters. I will cleanse you from your impurities. I will honor my name through your lives. I will be sanctified through your lives. I will do it. I will change your heart and give you a heart of flesh, a one heart that will desire my status, to follow me, to put me first, to be the priority in your life. I will cause this to happen in your life because I love you, because I created you for my glory, to glorify my name and be glorified through you, my children. I love you, I love you, I love you. Seek my love and seek my face continually. Be in that place of worship. I have put a song in your mouth, a new song that will help you through those times of a struggle. As you sing and lift up your voice and sing the songs that come from my spirit, you are making warfare. You are decreeing my holiness in your life and my power in your life and my love for you. These are your weapons. Use the weapons I have given you to defeat, to resist the evil one, to submit to the Lord, and the evil will flee from you. This is my promise, my declaration, says the Lord. I have good plans for you. I have good plans for you. My love, my provisions will always be there for you. Even if there is famine around you, even if there is adversity around you, I am giving you my word. As you keep climbing up the mountain, Mount Zion, the heavenly Jerusalem, as you continue allowing my cleansing waters to wash away your guilt, to cleanse you for the blood in your hands, I'm telling you now, this is my declaration over your life. I rejoice over you. I rejoice giving you goodness and plentiful of my wheat and my oil and my wine for your joy, for you to rejoice, my child. I'm blessing you. I'm blessing your life. Come near me. Come to the waters. Come to the waters. Come to the waters. The waters are here. The waters are here to cleanse and purify, to strengthen you and refresh you. This is my body. This is my blood. And as you partake of it, my waters are flowing through you. As you partake of my sufferings, as you partake of denying yourself and taking your cross daily. I am pouring out my abundance over you, Lion. I love you, my child, and I bless you. I bless you. I bless you. And we bless you, Jesus. And we bless you, Lord. You are worthy. You are worthy. You are worthy. You are worthy.
King of glory, you're mighty in battle, you're worthy of blessing, and all honor and power, you're the great King of glory, you're mighty in battle, you're worthy.
Judge thy people with righteousness, and thy poor with judgment. The mountains shall bring peace to the people in the little hills by righteousness. He will judge the poor of the people, and he shall save the children. He shall save the children. He shall save the children of the needy, and he shall break in pieces the oppressor. They shall fear thee as long as the sun and the moon endure throughout all generations. He shall come down like rain upon the mown grass, as showers that water the earth. In his days the righteous flourish in abundance of peace, so long as the moon endures. What I hear the Lord saying, he says, this is the error in which my kingdom does not come by observation. He says, but I come down like the rain upon the grass, and like showers that water the earth. That's how my dealings are in the earth. My judgments, my justice, my peace, my abundance, all distributed as I pour myself into the earth as the rain. The rain will come and water and cause to flourish that which is destined to flourish and bring peace, that which needs to be brought to completeness. But it will also bring judgment and establish justice so that all will fear before me until there is no more moon. I come to establish my fear in your midst and the fear again in your nation. I'm coming as the rain to water. I'm coming as the judge to judge. And yes, the mountains will bring peace to the people and the little hills by righteousness. And the righteous will flourish. And it's interesting. I looked up the word flourish. It's parach, Hebrew. Listen to what it means. To bud, to sprout, to shoot, to bloom, to send out, to break out as of leprosy, and to fly. God will cause us to flourish, us the righteous. This is our hour to bud, to sprout, to shoot, to bloom, to break out and to fly. The Lord declares this over each one of us this evening. It's time for you to bud, to break out, to sprout, to shoot, to bloom, to fly. Break out, bud, sprout, shoot, bloom, fly. Break out, sprout, shoot, bloom, blood, bud, fly. And that fly means to extend your wings. That meaning you believe the wind favors you. Is the wind in your favor? It is. It is in favor of the righteous. But the wicked cannot endure it. Now listen to this. The word peace, of course. Hebrew word shalom. But peace doesn't do it justice. So he's coming to bring abundance of peace. And listen to what it means. It means peace. But beyond that, it's a broader meaning. Completeness, soundness, welfare, completeness in number, safety, soundness in body, welfare, health, prosperity, quiet, tranquility, contentment. It can also mean friendship. Of human relationships with God, especially in covenant relationship. So God is coming to bring completeness, soundness, welfare, peace, soundness of body, health, prosperity, tranquility. So he says, in my days you will flourish, but you cannot know my flourishing if you don't allow me to reign upon you. My rain that comes down that actually brings my reign of peace. For is it not written that the king shall reign in righteousness? And he is the prince of peace. He is the prince of shalom. He is the prince that causes you to flourish, to fly, to blood, to shoot forth, and to break out on the right hand and on the left. And this is your hour to bloom, the Lord says. This is your hour for the rain is coming down. is being sent upon you in this hour.
Thank you.
I just saw an intestinal tract straightening out. There's a blockage someplace. I just saw it straightening out. You know, I don't get things like that. That just expanded me. But I just saw inside and saw this, something happening with it. Wow. I saw there were many healings that were going on. Do you know the purpose of what's happening right now? This is gonna sound, it's kind of strange, but do you know the purpose of what we're doing right now isn't for the manifestation of healings? Did you know? Do you know why there were healings around Jesus? Did you know why? He came to heal, of course, to save. Because if you read Matthew, every time someone got healed, he'd say, the kingdom of God has come unto you. It's because of the very presence of him whose government is light and no darkness can exist. So as we were just releasing, it is natural for healings to take place. I never grow cold when that happens and healings happen. It's just I just was seeing someone's intestines straightening out, things in the lower, like gastro, you know, that system down there, you know. And I hear him saying, yes, I will get down and I will get down into the dirty grime with you and pull you out and heal you. But as we were releasing light, giving him glory, and just focusing on him, not on what we get from him, focusing on him, he was doing all this. He's been doing all this. It's amazing. It's amazing. Open our eyes so that we can see you moving, because just like Jesus, you keep saying this, he didn't use his intelligence to figure things out. He used his intelligence to recognize you and do what he saw you doing. So Father, we see you moving. You sent word to prophets and apostles, and the word was engage the throne room. To engage the throne room and bless the Lord. To bless the Lord. And in our worship that he would bind those kings. He will expose the darkness. And in the midst, he'll heal us. For I have elevated you today, and I hear your song, for it's my song too. And I join in the song with you. I've opened up your ears to hear the angels sing, and I say it's true. I have seated you with me here in this place. Now come up here, come up here, come up here. There's so much I need to show you. Dance over us with great joy. Zephaniah. Thank you.
Thank you. go home and read it. Amen. It's the word of God. It's the word of God. Hallelujah. Believe it. Believe it. It's yours.
Thank you.
Below the lowest valley, you are beyond the angels. now, and I'll show it to thee. Is there anything too hard for me? Is there anything too hard for me? Reach out and see my wonder.
think Ken was right at the beginning. I mean, just a little while ago when he said, well, this never happens to me that I call out a healing, because this is something new that God wants to do with each one of us. He wants to pour out his gifts to us, and that healings and will happen, healings of all type. The blind will see, the lame will walk, demons will be cast out, and the deaf will hear. And all this, in each one of your ministries, God wants to pour out his spirit to us. All he asks of us is our obedience, our yes, our docility to the Holy Spirit. And he will do these things in our midst. Great miracles will happen.
See, you are holy
Jesus. Your judgments are right and true. They are right and true. And the governments of this earth, the kingdoms of this earth, will bow down and will confess you are the King of all the kingdoms. Of all the kingdoms.